My full name is Christopher George Abi-Nader, but I go by Chris. I am 19 years old, unemployed university student that is trying to get his bachelor's degree in computer science as safely as possible. My passions are cars, cats, video games, football, not American football, soccer football, and we can consider this also coping mechanisms for the current situation that I am undergoing in life. And I live alone in Lebanon, no family, they live abroad, trying to do my best to be as healthy as I can. I'm trying to love myself, I'm trying to take care of myself, and I'm especially trying to be myself in this country. To become a man of value, you have to be respected, you have to be disciplined, and you must have integrity, in my opinion. And you have to bring value to your society, of course, but this is the same for both parties, men and women. But the thing is that one is going to do it differently from the other. The man must bring value to his society by helping its family, by working his ass off, for example, at his job, being able to provide for others to eat, to survive, whilst a woman would take care of the family or her loved ones in a different way, as I mean, taking care of her environment, taking care of her loved ones, but by giving them the healthcare, giving them the attention that they need. Not therapy, but something that can help you continue on with life. To become a man of value, in my opinion, you must have integrity, you must be respected, and you must be disciplined. That's for sure. I did indeed struggle with some mental health issues, some that were caused by people and some that came naturally. The one that came naturally was ADHD, also known as Attention Deficit Hyperactivity Disorder, which I am still fighting, and it is honestly going pretty well. But the anger issues was temporary, because I was living in such a bad environment that has to do with my school, my old school, Lebanese school, that we could also see it as a coping mechanism, because it was something that was relieving me on the inside. Someone and some things. There is someone, I have attended multiple private mental health seminars, so that I could try to cope with it, especially for therapy, that really helped me a lot, especially when it comes to ADHD. For anger issues, I didn't really attend anything. The only thing that I used, I'm not a user, I didn't smoke, I don't drink, I'm someone that really stresses enough the fact that you should keep a clean sheet. So, again, my passions really helped me a lot. Video games, cats, cars, anything that I've mentioned before, I've definitely done it to get rid of my mental health issues. And that's it, yeah. Thank you. the norms and values of dating are slowly becoming, it's just slowly deteriorating. Like, it's self-explanatory. Divorce rates are increasing. Most relationships don't work out nowadays. Cheating is becoming normal. I think that people think they have too many options, especially in a world where social media is part of everyone's life at this point. Most people's life, I would say 80%, I'm not sure. But for people that have social media, they do know that they have multiple other options. If, for example, their relationship doesn't work out, I've come to the realization that you have to be very picky in this generation, especially with everything that is going on. A lot of people are going through transitions. I don't want to get into it, but I understand, to be honest. It's just very hard to be in to trust someone at that point. It takes more efforts and more dedication if you want to be in a relationship nowadays. I have been in a relationship. It was pretty healthy. I'm not gonna bring up too many points about it. But what I can say is that I knew that it wasn't gonna work out. And anyway, it didn't last long, and I'm happy that it didn't last long, because if it lasted longer, it would have affected me in a way I think I wouldn't recover from, because she was also my first love. And I do, like, I deep down inside, I wish it would have worked the way it should have, but it just wasn't possible. We did want each other, but we were just not compatible. I don't like to talk about this normally, but like, yes, I am happy that some of them ended, but I am also not happy that others ended. Some of them, I'm happy that they ended because I have realized after a while that I didn't lose them, they've lost me. They were toxic towards me, they were fake friends, high school stuff, basically, everyone goes through it at one point. But the ones that were genuine towards me and the ones that helped me, I did repulse some of them, which I still regret till this day. But it's fine. You always make new contacts. You learn from your mistakes. It's something that you will imperatively learn from and go through with your life. I do miss them. Yes, I also do miss them. But again, it is what it is. I don't really want to question it. I just moved on. I just continued with my life. I just can't relapse all the time. I can't rely on the past. I don't want to go through depression again. So I am just somewhat happy with the way my social circle is constructed. Truly life-changing impact. Definitely a psychologically safe environment to reflect and get support. But it has to be reciprocated. It can't be one-sided, or else it's not even a friendship. And it would be oblivious to keep them in your life. If you want any examples, they've my real friends. They've been here during my highs and lows. They've always stuck by my side. I'm really grateful for them and I really love them. So Yeah. It has been improving throughout this year. I've been definitely working on myself. I'm definitely happy that I've been working on myself. I am happy that things are getting into place. I can see me working for my goals. I'm just very happy overall. There's just nothing else to say. Very grateful that I was able to adopt this mentality that was able to change my life. Oh, seek help as soon as you can. I'm not even joking. It's like, the issues will not go away and they will pop up eventually and you will have to deal with them. You cannot, like, they will always negatively impact you if you don't deal with them appropriately. And I wish you the best with those problems. But please try to sort it out as soon as you can, because it's something that you will regret it in the future. The bill of regret is actually insane. And I had a first glimpse of it, and fortunately I escaped it. I didn't have to pay it. So do the same, okay? Everyone has potential. Maybe some do more than others, but you definitely have potential. Do not put your life to waste. You can do it. If you're going through a tough time, I believe in you. You can do it. You can get out of it. It's just very difficult. And if you end up getting out of it and surviving, you are a fighter, a real warrior, and I'm very proud of you. What does Mario say to Peach when he wants to break up? He says, "I'm sorry, it's not you, it's me, Mario! Yahoo!"